Hello everyone and welcome back to another Mecha Model Kit review. It has been some time, hasn't it? Anyways, today we're taking a look at the high-grade Infinitism Kotetsu Jig, so let's get right into it. Of course, as you guys know, I can't start the video off without giving a proper thank you to my channel sponsor, Galactic Toys. They sent me this kit for free, so as always, a big thank you goes out to them. Now, unfortunately, my discount code is not currently working on their website. However, I do still strongly encourage that you shop there and show them some love if you're looking for some awesome mecha model kits. You can find their website with the affiliate link down in the description, and with that being said, let's get into the review. Now, for those of you who aren't really familiar with Kotetsu Jig or what it is, I'm not going to bore you with the details, but I will say it's an old super robot series created by Go Nagai and Toei Animation, and this model kit has reimagined the design of what it would look like if it was in the Mazinger Z Infinity movie. I don't believe Jig was actually in the movie, it's just a continuation of Bandai's model kit line. I really do hope if Bandai continues the Infinitism line that they plan on making more mechs like this one that weren't actually in the movie. I can't really say I'm personally a huge fan of adding panel lines everywhere on the kit for the sake of a modern appearance, but if it means we could potentially get some new, good-looking kits of old designs, I'm all for it. Now, I really did enjoy building this kit, and I'll say right off the bat, I think it's definitely worth your time and money. It's a pretty faithful recreation of a classic design, and it comes with a decent amount of accessories, which we'll get into later. I had a lot of fun building this kit. It's a very unique construction. Honestly, anything like this or the Ava kits is a really nice thing to mix up when you've been building a lot of Gundams, so it's a very good refresher. I'll also say, in terms of the construction, the color separation on this thing was handled beautifully. There are absolutely no stickers that come with this kit. Everything you see is pure plastic color separation, and it's beautiful. And now, while I did not panel line this one myself, as you can see, there are also plenty of opportunities for panel lining on this thing just absolutely everywhere. Overall, I'm very pleased with how the build went, and I'm even more pleased with the finished result. Now, the kit does come in at around $65 retail, and to some of you, that may seem kind of steep for a high grade, but to me, I think it's a pretty fair price. Considering this thing is nearly the size of a master grade and we get a fair amount of accessories, I personally have no complaints. For a more in-depth size comparison, here's the Kotetsu Jig next to the Super Robot Chogokin Volfog, a Master Grade model kit, and a Ray plush, fuck it. Now, I do have to stop gushing about this kit to bring up an unfortunate aspect that I noticed when handling this thing, and that is that the feet don't exactly do the best job of keeping this thing upright, even in less dynamic poses. It's not horrible, but it can be a bit frustrating, and if you want to attach that Mock Drill backpack to his back, you can just throw all hope you had out the window. Thankfully, to mitigate, this Bandai included a very nice action base with this. We also get two action base connectors, a very standard one, and we get this very unique looking one. This piece is form fitting to his lower torso, and it allows you to easily place him in some very good looking flying poses. There's even an articulation gimmick in the neck that allows the head to look very far upward, so it looks even better in those flying poses. Bandai really did think of everything here. Back to talking about the Mock Drill, there's not really that much to say here. However, you can detach both the drills and attach them to Jig's arms so he can use them as melee weapons like he does in the show. In fact, the whole kit is engineered to be pretty modular, just like this. The whole gimmick behind Jig originally was that his joints are made of magnets, so he can kind of mix and match his limbs to make all sorts of crazy combinations. I mean, the manual literally instructs you that you can build an abomination against God as a selling point. We also get two extra hands included, one fist to replace the other expressive open hand, and we get this pair of connected fists, which are to recreate the knuckle bomber attack. You can attach it to the wrist like this to have him prep for the attack. You can also use this effect part that comes with it, combined with another stand arm that we get in the box, to recreate the attack in motion when the fists are actually in flight, and my god, this looks beautiful. Now, Jig is a mainly melee combat based mecha, right? And even the box acknowledges this fact. Which is why I was a little bit disappointed to find that when handling this thing, I found the articulation to be disappointing in some places and just downright frustrating in others. The bend in the elbow is barely a 90 degree, and we have barely any up and down foot movement here. Not to mention there's almost no movement in the waist at all. He can't even really do a kick out to the front. I mean, you can kinda get the leg up there, but it looks extremely unnatural. However, I think my biggest gripe with the articulation of this kit comes down to how it actually feels trying to pose this thing. And I can really only describe it as finicky and frustrating. You don't have to worry about the model kit falling apart on you, it's actually pretty solid. However, the problem is that the joints are just weird, like the swivel is inside of the joint rather than up in the bicep or something like that. When you try to move a limb a certain way, chances are the joint is also going to kind of move its own way. It definitely doesn't pose like any other conventional Gunpla kit that you may have handled before. There's also this weird little sliding gimmick in the hips that I really found doesn't do that much at all, it just makes it a little more annoying to handle. You really do kind of just have to finagle with it and hold the joints in place if you want to rotate the legs or arms independently. It's not anything infuriating, but it definitely does require require a lot more finesse to get him into the right pose than it would with a Gunpla kit. However, thanks to the inclusion of the action base, once you get him up on there, you really shouldn't have too much of a problem getting him into a good looking pose. Now, he can't pull off anything insanely dynamic, but you can make him look very good. So that's it for my review of the high grade Infinitism Kotetsu Jig. As you could probably tell, I do enjoy this kit quite a bit, and I can give it a fairly solid recommendation to anyone looking up to pick up something new. At best, it's a modernized but still quite faithful redesign that brings a lot of fun options to the table, and I think any Go Nagai fan would be happy to have this in their collection. At worst, it's, I guess, a little bit quirky. But yeah, those are my thoughts on the kit, and I hope you enjoyed the overall video. As you can see, I'm kind of playing around with a new video style that condenses my original style of videos down a lot more. This way, it won't be a chore for me to make them, and it won't be a chore for you to watch them, but it still captures that original feel and still remains informative. If you have any thoughts you'd like to share, comments, criticisms, critiques, etc., as always, feel free to leave those down in the comments. But that's going to be it for me today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.
I wish that I could turn back time.